Bourbon whiskey. Bourbon whiskey is a type of American whiskey, a barrel-aged distilled spirit made primarily from corn. The name ultimately derives from the French Bourbon dynasty, although the precise inspiration for the whiskey's name is uncertain. Contenders include Bourbon County in Kentucky and Bourbon Street in New Orleans, both of which are named after the dynasty. Bourbon has been distilled since the 18th century. The use of the term bourbon for the whiskey has been traced to the 1820s, with consistent use beginning in Kentucky in the 1870s. Although bourbon may be made anywhere in the United States, it is strongly associated with the American South and with Kentucky in particular. As of 2014, distillers' wholesale market revenue for bourbon sold within the U.S. was about $2.7 billion, and bourbon made up about two-thirds of the $1.6 billion of U.S. exports of distilled spirits. Distilling was most likely brought to present-day Kentucky in the late 18th century by Scots, Scots-Irish, and other settlers who began to farm the area in earnest. The origin of bourbon as a distinct form of whiskey is not well documented. There are many conflicting legends and claims, some more credible than others. For example, the invention of bourbon is often attributed to Elijah Craig, a Baptist minister and distiller credited with many Kentucky firsts, who is said to have been the first to age the product in charred oak casks, a process that gives bourbon its reddish color and distinctive taste. Across the county line in Bourbon County, an early distiller named Jacob Spears is credited with being the first to label his product as bourbon whiskey. Spears' home, known as Stone Castle, Warehouse, and Spring House, survive. The home is on Clay Kaiser Road. Although still popular and often repeated, the Craig legend is apocryphal. Similarly, the Spears story is a local favorite but is rarely repeated outside the county. There likely was no single inventor of bourbon, which developed into its present form in the late 19th century. Essentially, any type of grain can be used to make whiskey, and the practice of aging whiskey and charring the barrels for better flavor had been known in Europe for centuries. The late date of the Bourbon County etymology has led Louisville historian Michael Veach to dispute its authenticity. He proposes the whiskey was named after Bourbon Street in New Orleans, a major port where shipments of Kentucky whiskey sold well as a cheaper alternative to French cognac. Another proposed origin of the name is the association with the geographic area known as Old Bourbon, consisting of the original Bourbon County in Virginia organized in 1785. This region included much of today's eastern Kentucky, including 34 of the modern counties. It included the current Bourbon County in Kentucky, which became a county when Kentucky separated from Virginia as a new state in 1792. Although many distilleries operated in Bourbon County historically, no distilleries operated there between 1919, when Prohibition began in Kentucky, and late 2014, when a small distillery opened, a period of 95 years. Prohibition was devastating to the bourbon industry. With the ratification of the 18th Amendment in 1919, all distilleries were forced to stop operating, although a few were granted permits to bottle existing stocks of medicinal whiskey. Later, a few were allowed to resume production when the stocks ran out. Distilleries that were granted permits to produce or bottle medicinal whiskey included Brown-Forman, Frankfort Distillery, James Thompson, and Brothers, American Medical Spirits, the Shelly Distillery, and the A.P.H. Stitzel Distillery. A refinement often dubiously credited to James C. Crowe is the sour mash process, which conditions each new fermentation with some amount of spent mash. Spent mash is also known as spent beer, distillers' spent grain, stillage, and slop or feed mash, so named because it is used as animal feed. The acid introduced when using the sour mash controls the growth of bacteria that could taint the whiskey and creates a proper pH balance for the yeast to work. A concurrent resolution adopted by the United States Congress in 1964 declared bourbon to be a distinctive product of the United States and asked the appropriate agencies of the United States government to take appropriate action to prohibit importation into the United States of whiskey designated as bourbon whiskey. Federal regulation now defines bourbon whiskey to only include bourbon produced in the United States. In recent years, bourbon and Tennessee whiskey, sometimes regarded as a different type of spirit but generally meets the legal requirements to be called bourbon, have enjoyed significant growth in popularity. The industry trade group Distilled Spirits Council of the United States tracks sales of bourbon and Tennessee whiskey together. According to the Distilled Spirits Council, during 2009 to 2014, the volume of 9-liter cases of whiskey increased by 28.5% overall. Higher-end bourbon and whiskeys experienced the greatest growth. During 2009-14, The volume of the value segment increased by 12.1%, premium by 25.8%, high-end premium by 27.8%, and super premium by 123.8%. Gross supply revenues for U.S. bourbon and Tennessee whiskey increased by 46.7% over the 2009-14 period, with the greatest growth coming from high-end products. In 2014, more than 19 million 9-liter cases of bourbon and Tennessee whiskey were sold in the U.S., generating almost $2.7 billion in wholesale distillery revenue. U.S. exports of bourbon whiskey surpassed $1 billion for the first time in 2013. Distillers hailed the rise of a golden age of Kentucky bourbon and predicted further growth. In 2014, it was estimated that U.S. bourbon whiskey exports surpassed $1 billion, making up the majority of the U.S. total of $1.6 billion in spirits exports. Major export markets for U.S. spirits are, in descending order, Canada, the United Kingdom, Germany, Australia, and France. The largest percentage increases in U.S. exports were, in descending order, Brazil, the Dominican Republic, Bahamas, Israel, and United Arab Emirates. Key elements of growth in the market showing the largest increases have been changes of law, trade agreements, and reductions of tariffs, as well as increased consumer demand for premium category spirits. Bourbon's legal definition varies somewhat from country to country, but many trade agreements require the name bourbon to be reserved for products made in the United States. The U.S. regulations for labeling and advertising bourbon apply only to products made for consumption within the United States. They do not apply to distilled spirits made for export. Canadian law requires products labeled bourbon to be made in the United States and also to conform to their requirements that apply within the United States. But in countries other than the United States and Canada, products labeled bourbon may not adhere to THESME standards. For example, in the European Union, products labeled as bourbon are not required to conform to all the regulations that apply within the United States, although they still must be made in the U.S. The Federal Standards of Identity for Distilled Spirits state that bourbon made for U.S. consumption must be. Bourbon has no minimum specified duration for its aging period. Products aged for as little as 3 months are sold as bourbon. The exception is straight bourbon, which has a minimum aging requirement of 2 years. In addition, any bourbon aged less than 4 years must include an age statement on its label. Bourbon that meets the above requirements, has been aged for a minimum of 2 years, and does not have added coloring, flavoring, or other spirits may be but is not required to be, called straight bourbon. Bottled and bond bourbon is a subcategory of straight bourbon and must be aged at least 4 years. Bourbon that is labeled blended may contain added coloring, flavoring, and other spirits, such as unaged neutral grain spirits, but at least 51% of the product must be straight bourbon. Bourbon that has been aged for fewer than 3 years cannot legally be referred to as whiskey in the EU. On May 4, 1964, the United States Congress recognized bourbon whiskey as a distinctive product of the United States by concurrent resolution. Bourbon may be produced anywhere in the United States where it is legal to distill spirits, but most brands are produced in Kentucky, where bourbon production is a strong historical association. The filtering of iron-free water through the high concentrations of limestone that are unique to the area is often touted by bourbon distillers in Kentucky as a signature step in the bourbon-making process. On August 2, 2007, the U.S. Senate passed a resolution sponsored by Senator Jim Bunning officially declaring September 2007 to be National Bourbon Heritage Month, commemorating the history of bourbon whiskey. Notably, the resolution claimed that Congress had declared bourbon to be America's native spirit in its 1964 resolution. However, the 1964 resolution did not contain such a statement. It declared bourbon to be a distinctive product identifiable with the United States. The resolution was passed again in 2008. As of 2014, approximately 95% of all bourbon is produced in Kentucky, according to the Kentucky Distillers Association. The state has more than 5.3 million barrels of bourbon that are aging, a number that exceeds the state's population. Bardstown, Kentucky, is home to the annual Bourbon Festival held each September. It has been called the Bourbon Capital of the World by the Bardstown Tourism Commission and the Kentucky Bourbon Festival organizers, who have registered the phrase as a trademark. The Kentucky Bourbon Trail is the name of a tourism promotion program organized by the Kentucky Distillers Association that is aimed at attracting visitors to the distilleries in Kentucky, particularly Four Roses, Heaven Hill, Jim Beam, Maker's Mark, Town Branch, Wild Turkey, and Woodford Reserve. Tennessee is home to other major bourbon makers, although most prefer to call their product Tennessee whiskey instead, including Giant Jack Daniel *S. It is legally defined under Tennessee House Bill 1084, the North American Free Trade Agreement, and at least one other international trade agreement is the recognized name for a straight bourbon whiskey produced in Tennessee. It is also required to meet the legal definition of bourbon under Canadian law. Although some Tennessee whiskey makers maintain that a state-mandated pre-aging filtration through chunks of maple charcoal, known as the Lincoln County process, make its flavor distinct from bourbon, U.S. regulations defining bourbon neither require nor prohibit its use. Prior to 2013, the Lincoln County process was not legally required for products identified as Tennessee whiskey. Bourbon also was and is made in other U.S. states. The largest bourbon distiller outside of Kentucky and Tennessee is MGP of Indiana, which primarily wholesales its spirits products to bottling companies that sell them under about 50 different brand names, in some cases, misleadingly marketed as craft whiskey, despite being produced at a large wholesaler's factory. To be legally sold as bourbon, the whiskey smash bill requires a minimum of 51% corn, with the remainder being any cereal grain. A mash bill that contains wheat instead of rye produces what is known as a wheated bourbon. The grain is ground and mixed with water. Usually mash from a previous distillation is added to ensure consistency across batches, creating a sour mash. Finally, yeast is added, and the mash is fermented. It is distilled to between 65% and 80% alcohol using either a traditional alembic or the much less expensive continuous still. Most modern bourbons are initially run off using a column still and then redistilled in a doubler that is basically a pot still. The resulting clear spirit, called White Dog, is placed in charred new oak containers for aging. In practice, these containers are generally barrels made from American white oak. The spirit gains its color and much of its flavor from the caramelized sugars and vanillins in the charred wood. Straight bourbon must be aged at least 2 years, and blended bourbon must contain at least 51% straight bourbon on a proof gallon basis. The remainder of the spirits in a blended bourbon may be neutral grain spirits that are not aged at all. If a product is labeled merely as bourbon whiskey rather than straight or blended, no specific minimum aging period is prescribed, only that the product has been stored at not more than 62.5% alcohol by volume in charred new oak containers. Bourbons gain more color and flavor the longer they age in wood. Changes to the spirit also occur due to evaporation and chemical processes such as oxidation. Lower-priced bourbons tend to be aged relatively briefly. Even for higher-priced bourbons, maturity rather than a particular age duration is often the goal, as overaging bourbons can negatively affect the flavor of the bourbon. After maturing, bourbon is withdrawn from the barrel and is typically filtered and diluted with water. It is then bottled at no less than 80 U.S. proof. Although most bourbon whiskey is sold at 80 U.S. proof, other common proofs are 86, 90, and 100. All bottled and bond bourbon is 100 proof. Some higher proof bottlings are marketed as barrel proof, meaning they have not been diluted or have been only lightly diluted after removal from the barrels. Bourbon whiskey may be sold at less than 80 proof but must be labeled as diluted bourbon. After processing, barrels remain saturated with up to 10 gallons of bourbon, although 2 to 3 is the norm. They may not be reused for bourbon, and most are sold to distilleries in Canada, Scotland, Ireland, Mexico, and the Caribbean for aging other spirits. Some are employed in the manufacture of various barrel-aged products, including amateur and professionally brewed bourbon barrel-aged beer, barbecue sauce, wine, hot sauce, and others. Since 2011, Jim Beam has employed barrel rinsing on a large scale to extract bourbon from its used barrels, mixing the extract with a 6-year-old Beam bourbon to create a 90-proof product that it sells as Devil's Cut. The bottling operation for bourbon is the process of filtering, mixing together straight whiskey from different barrels, diluting with water, blending with other ingredients, and filling containers to produce the final product that is marketed to consumers. By itself, the phrase bottled by means only that. Only if the bottler operates the distillery that produced the whiskey may distilled by be added to the label. Labeling requirements for bourbon and other alcoholic beverages are defined in the U.S. Code of Federal Regulations. No whiskey made outside the United States may be labeled bourbon or sold as bourbon inside the United States. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.